All right, sod it. We're going to Thirsk. I give up. Just my reasoning is that while Claudius has been enjoying his time off, he's getting a bit stir crazy, and we're going up to Thirsk just out of pure curiosity, if nothing else. Oh yes, mannequins have moved again. I don't really. I think Hermias Mora is playing tricks on me, possibly. Incidentally, I have been hearing black book noises every now and again when I come in here, which can't be good. So I think we know who's behind these shenanigans right now. Ugh. Backpack. Cloak. Oh, I've decided, by the way, that Claudius looks kind of badass with a circlet on, with this armor, for some reason. This armor and this cloak and a circlet? Yeah. Looks kind of cool, I think. Anyway, and it works with the hood as well, ain't that cool? That's kind of why I want to get an armored hood. Let's see, Ring of Remedy's fine. Amulet of Talus is good. We've got a hammer. We've got a shield. Let's go. Oh, shit. Right, yeah. Before we go, actually. Some people have been asking me about Claudius' pumping iron stats, and I'm going to do it now just because otherwise I'll forget. And it'll be another bazillion episodes before I remember to do it again. His body weight is now 67.217 blah blah blah. Current training zero because he's been resting for like days on end. But yeah, he started off, I believe, at body weight 10. He's now gone up to body weight 67, which is mad. You've been doing a lot of working out, haven't you, mate? Yeah, if... Hold on. There you go. He's looking pretty hench, actually, compared to the way he was at the start of the LP. I mean, it's impressive, really. But then again, he's level 40-something, so... Anyway. Can I just point out, by the way, since I've had a lot of time to sit around and do nothing and listen to it... The music for the Dragonborn DLC, the specially composed music for it, is gorgeous. It really is. It's slightly Lord of the Ringsy, actually, I've noticed. But, yeah, it's fucking gorgeous. I love it. It's so good. So you should not thirsty, not tired. Jolly good. It's 8 AM? Yeah. Okay, let's go on an expedition to Thirsk. Why not? We really have nothing better to do. And, you know, it's just a way to kill the time. And I have a sneaking suspicion as well that it might have something to do with Hrothmund's Barrow. Possibly. Because I'm not entirely 100% convinced Bethesda would bother putting Hrothmund's Barrow in the game unless it was part of a quest. I mean, to put it in the game again. I mean, it was part of a quest the first time around, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, it was. You had to get an amulet from there. For heaven's sake, there we go. Yes, hello everybody. I'll go to the work at Colbjorn Barrett. Where are these mercenaries then?
We've got a crew on it. They're not sharp, but they're working hard. Come back soon.
Yeah, I'm amazed you managed to hire anybody, frankly, at this point. Nice tent, though. Volume 19, Volume 21. We've read those already. Shall take those 6 septims. I can only assume that that's his tent, anyway. Yeah, okay, cool. Well, you keep working. Doing stuff. My goodness. Oh, it's one of you lot. Now, someone's told me that apparently... Well, they said I could blow him out of the sky with one hit with Fus Radar, but I disintegrated him anyway, so I guess it kind of doesn't matter. There we go. That is so cool. I can disintegrate people. Oh. The fireworm thing would also be kind of awesome. But obviously I don't have all three words, so... Whoa. Epic hammer death animations there, Claudius. I approve. Let's try and sort through this mess of ash hoppers. Right, Thirsk is just pretty much... Well, it's just north, isn't it, really? You can't go far wrong. This place is pretty small, after all. It's... an ash hopper fighting an ash spawn. Who will win? Answer is Claudius wins. Right, you're, tough cookie. Now where's the... Where are you? There you are. Oh, not you, but fine. You can die as well. Nice. There was an ash hopper here somewhere that he was fighting. Whatever. Never mind. Ah, damn. I wanted ebony ore. That's what I need at the moment. I need one more ebony ingot and I can make a pair of boots. Please, sir. Just one more ebony ingot and I can have a pair of shoes. But, no, really, seriously, though, I only need one more. I've melted down everything I can, except for... the Mace of Eivor Stone Singer, which for obvious reasons, or what should be obvious reasons, I'm not going to melt that thing down ever. Dragon. Am I just paranoid now, or did I actually hear a dragon? Okay, well, moving on. My Dover senses are tingling. Burn Spriggan. Someone did suggest to me an Ashlands sort of landscape overhaul in the end, actually. Alas, it's a little bit late for that, I'm afraid, because we're not going to be here much longer. But still, kind of cool. I will keep it in mind for future playthroughs. Oh, green grass. Oh, to see Riverwood again and Falkreath. Oh. I miss them so, I do. Oh, hello. Over here. Blocking is a thing, Claudius, in case you'd forgotten. Oh, fuck you, dude. I was hoping he'd disintegrate, but, you know. We killed him in the end, anyway. Hmm. Can't wait to open that. I might as well. Steel bolts. Very good. Oh, come on, game. Oh, dear God. There's a half a dozen things behind me that want me dead. You've got to be kidding me. Killed by one of those fucking things? Oh, God. Didn't even explode, it just stood next to me and I died. Oh, God, I so very much hating. So very much hate having to redo treks through the wilderness. Like this. Right then, you little... I do love how shouting increases your speechcraft in Skyrim. Thank you very much for the stuff. Now then, where's the marauding ash hunter? There he is! Just wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute. Just a little longer, and we're good. Oh, I wish I'd known about this sooner. Quick save. Now then. I think we carried on this way, or was it this way? I think this way. Yes, it was this way. Ooh, creep clusters. Useful for making potions, or so I recall. Not 100% certain. Never ran about anything, really. What the hell's that I can hear? Is there an ash spawn around here somewhere? It sounds like it. High Point Tower. Aha! Oh well. I was half hoping I'd have a nice little dungeon there to distract me, but never mind. We're practically going east. We need to go north. Oh, hello. Oh, I really need to shout more often. Good way to increase your old speechcraft skill, I suppose. Oh, you bloody greater venerable burnt spriggan. Get out of here. Oh god, now there's a fucking ash hopper somewhere that million miles away, yeah, that's taking pot shots at me. Wonderful. It's dead. Good, right. You little bastard! Come here and die. Oof. Well, at least I was rewarded with a level up for my troubles. Great and venerable burnt spriggan, please. Health. I suppose stamina wouldn't be such a bad idea every now and again, considering stamina actually increases your carrying capacity, which I sometimes forget. Right, fuck smithing, because it doesn't work. It's broken. What can we do instead? Titan. Reducing all incoming stagger by 50%. Not bad. What does it lead to? Not bad. Not bad. Ooh, not bad also. I wonder if that extends to crossbow bolts. Be nice if it did. That's light shields. That's shattering. I don't want to do that, as I recall, because I want to pick up enemy weapons rather than destroy them. Power bash. It's tempting. I don't really do power bashes. Well, obviously I don't do power bashes because I don't have the power bash perk, but oh, this one's got ranks to it. I'm doing alright with my time blocks when I remember to do them, actually, so that's not such a big deal. Dual flurry. Two wielding attacks are 20% faster and deal 10% less damage. No, that doesn't sound like such a great thing. honestly. Bonebreaker. 40% of armor ignored. Oh, wait, let's have a look at other stuff. Marksmanship. Now, I'm looking for... where is it? Alchemy, maybe? Adhesive explosives. You can create adhesive explosives at the cooking pot that can be applied to your weapon or reverse pickpocketed onto the target that detonate after a short time. Wow. Batman or what? Eating an ingredient reveals its first two effects. Nice. Potions you mix that restore health and magic cross down are 25% more powerful. Where's enchanting? This I could do with, really. Yeah. Okay. Is that snow I see ahead of me? I think it might be. Slightly brighter color than the ash. Ooh. Oh! Hello! What's all this then? We don't know who this belongs to yet. Kagrimez. As in Kagrimez Resonance Gem? Aha! Uh-huh. I may regret this, but... fine. Okay. Dwemer Ruin, lots of shock magic. Need this. Suppose I don't really need. Oh, it does have frost resistance, so. Where the fuck is the hood? That's what I wanted to take off. Oh, hell yeah. Badass mode activated, right. Don't spider things usually pop out of these? This one's dead. Lantern? Somebody's been here. Reavers. Right. Oh, you wouldn't be you wouldn't be needing a resonance gem now, would you? Gosh, right now we don't actually know that these guys are reavers, do we? They seem like an unsavory bunch, but we don't know if they're actually reavers or bandits or whatever yet, so I can't just start taking pot shots at them. It'd be silly. So.
Is someone there?
Yeah, now they're attacking us, so, you know. Oh, god damn it, I fucked up the Futrodar. Never mind. Okay then. Night vision, please. Lockpick. A bug. And a necklace. Elven mace? Hmm. Kagrimez Resonance Gem. Aha! Right, more of those. Ralith Eldry's notes on Kagrimez. I am closer to solving the mystery of these ruins. I have found references in ancient Dwemer texts that call Karagrimair the site of a set of trials, a training ground of sorts. This is thus far unprecedented in my research. This could explain why that gate is so unmovable. The proper trial has not been completed. It is possible nobody has opened this gate since the days of the Dwemer. What treasures of the ancient world lie in wait behind these doors? The pattern on the gate seems to hold the solution to unlocking it. It bears resemblance to the console in the center of the chamber. But what does it mean? There are 9 holes that I assume are to be filled, but with what? If only I had the means to fund more expeditions to the other Dwemer ruins of Solthheim, they surely hold the keys to opening the locked gate. Even if I had the means to start the trials, I surely have not the means to complete them. I can't wait for more funding. I am going to have to recruit those who will act on the promise of treasure alone. Surely there are those as excited about this find as I am. Ralith Eldry. I'm guessing Ralith Eldry was probably killed by these guys. If I had to guess. More drums in the deep, lovely. So I suppose, yes, the resonance gems go in this. And we need 9 of them. 9 resonance gems for the mortal kings doomed to die. Well, wish I'd known about that a little sooner. I would have been on the lookout for these things. Oh, wait a minute. Okay. This works slightly differently to what I actually thought. Oh god, what have I done? Oh shit. Oh, this was a terrible idea. Goodness me, this is out of charge. Crap. Crap. Crap, crap, crap. Oh. Ow! Ow! Are you shooting round corners now? Oh. Pants. Oh, come on! Just notice these guys are doing almost no damage to me, which is kind of hilarious. Damn it. Okay. Find resonance gems across Solthheim to complete the Karagrimair's trials. Right, I see. Steadfast Dwarven Spider. It's an invisible Dwarven Spider is what it is. You seem friendly, invisible Dwarven Spider. If you weren't invisible, I'd be more interested. As it stands... No. Oh my. My goodness, that's a lot of dwarven ingots. Dwarven oil. A chest. Dragonbone ebon steel heavy shield. Well, I'll be damned. ...155 armor. God damn, that's a good shield. Oops, I just put it back in the chest, didn't I? I'm an idiot. Ebon steel, though, honestly. You're just making it up at this point, aren't you? Admit it. Still, damn. I am the Dragonborn of legend with a mighty shield made of dragon bone, like a dragon skull plate by the looks of things. Fuck yeah. I'm liking the look of that. I need to get this home and enchant it. And since I've improved my enchanting slightly with that last perk, good as an excuse as any. Yeah, right, so how many gems do I have? I've got 3, so I think I could do this one as well. Poor invisible dwarven spider. Someone's stolen your textures. It's not the first invisible thing I found in Skyrim, come to think of it. Oh god, I've forgotten what the bloody pattern was now. Yeah, I've come across invisible things before, I think. Oh, God knows why, right? Right. Maybe it's an immersive creatures problem. I certainly used to get that quite a lot with Mart's monster mod in Oblivion, so... Here we go. Fucking Christ! Now what? Oh boy. Dwarven Sweeper. Pleased to meet you. My name's Claudius. Oh god, there's... This is it's like Tomb Raider all over again. I'm friggin' 12 years old again and suffering at the hands of weirdly spiky flamey traps. That's a dwarven thing, isn't it? It's a tempered sphere. It looks big and nasty. Well, it seems to be ignoring me for now, so I'll ignore it. What the hell's shooting me? It's those spectres, isn't it? Ouch. Tempered sphere doesn't seem to be doing anything other than scratching its metal shin. All right then. So we want cowering behind there. I've never seen a ghost cower in fear before. How very odd. There we go. Ah, yes, hello. Come over here a bit so I can attempt to disintegrate you with my thwom. Are you stuck? It'd be a shame if you were stuck, honestly. Oh, here we go. Oh, cool! Didn't think that would work, honestly. I think he was a bit confused. That is a very, very big mace. Glad it was confused, frankly. Right then, well. Can't say I'm the biggest fan of this place already, but it's not posed any serious threat so far. Admittedly. Very flashy though, with all the traps and whatnot. Yeah, one cannot help but wonder what is actually lying in here in wait, however. I mean, if they decided to guard it with this many ludicrous traps and guardians and things, I feel like I might be able to unleash some sort of ancient evil upon the world. Hello. You're not invisible. You've got a funny looking face. He's like staring up at me. You also seem friendly. Attention, robot! Initiate oogly boogly followy protocol. Yeah, God, it actually worked. Oh, well. Steel broadsword of ice. Nah. I'm gonna need 4 gems this time, right? This is as far as we go, Mr. Dwarven Sphere. Well, I wanted a companion, didn't I? It's just, not quite what I had in mind. You wanna come and help me defeat Mirag? Eh? Command. Oh, this is follower stuff. Should I set this as your place of residence, sir? Importance. We can make you essential! Protected! Can we even do that with a Dwarven Sphere, or is that going to crash the game as soon as he dies? I don't know, like, I feel like we ought to be able to repair a robot, at least, when it gets destroyed, rather than lose it forever. And again, not that we really know how to repair it, or I'm a robot, but then again, maybe they can repair themselves. You do look like, you do kind of look like a bit of pottery just following me around on the floor, you know that, right? Outfit. Yeah, on this guy. Train? Can we train our Dwarven Centurion Sphere? We apparently just did. I'm pretty sure this was designed with humanoid characters in mind, but this mod, but whatever. Okay. Part of me wants to sort of play this off as us not actually having told it to follow us. It's just sort of decided to of its own accord. Like it sort of has a mind of its own, and Claudius is a little bit confused and a little bit wary as to why on earth it's actually following us. But, it is, nevertheless. How on earth do you do that? Stop so suddenly on a slope when you're essentially a ball. Whatever. You're welcome to tag along, I guess. I don't know what good you'll do. Cloyd is, of course, being, I would imagine, unaware of the fact that he probably unfolds into some sort of killing machine, as far as he's aware. There's some sort of small Dwemer football following him around right now. What an amusing creature. Wonder what Neloth would think. Now, come on then. If you're gonna follow me, you might as well get on the lift. Come on then. Let's see you handle steps. Admirably. You've got one up on the Daleks then. I'll give you that. Well, I will grab this. Tribunal Mask Ebony, but it has no mesh in the menu, which means it might crash the game if I try to put it on, but I'm going to anyway. It's invisible. Okay. Never mind. That's just... Is it invisible when I drop it? Yes, it is. Christ, I don't know. Can we activate a campfire with a weapon that does fire damage? Guess not. What are you hissing at me for? Oh, you're going home, are you? Fine. Be that way. Oh, you changed your mind. What? Are you staying or going? What is it? What's it gonna be? Huh? Look, I've gotta go and, you know, kill ancient dragonborn and things. I can't have you faffing around. Getting in the way. And stuff. Fine. Yes. A small precipice. The bane of every AI companion. Let's see how you handle one. Not terribly well, it would seem. Steps. No problem. That, apparently a big problem. Oh god, I can see him lurking in the trees. Clever girl. Right. Okay, onwards to Thirsk. Fucking hell. Your clanking is going to get a little annoying after a while. I feel I must inform you of this. Oh, hello. What's all this? Ramshackle Trading Post. I don't think Ramshackle adequately covers it, frankly, but whatever. Whatever you say, game. A note. Meet me here at midnight. You know what, I'm half tempted to. East Empire Company Strongbox, right. Ugh. Just gotta find that sweet spot or end up in the same neighborhood as it, at least. There we go. Alright, I think I know roughly where we were with that one. Around there-ish. Come on. Come on. There we go. Get better at this, you know. East Empire Pendant. Ruby Sapphires, Health Potions, Rings of the Squire. Septims, the lot. What time is it? 12:23 PM. Well, we've got 12 hours until we need to be back here then. I mean, assuming someone actually turns up, and we don't end up just sort of standing there at midnight in the ramshackle trading post looking like idiots. I should call you Wilson, shouldn't I, really? I mean, you are basically a football anyway, and you've got a face drawn on you. What, you have a problem with this slope, but not the others? Whatever, I'm heading on towards Thirsk, mate. You can catch up. This way. Ah, oh, hello. They can only be readers. No crossbows allowed. I'm the only one who's allowed to use crossbows. Them's the rules. You stick to them or you die. Alright, well, we just handled an expert one, so this shouldn't be a problem, surely. Oops. Apparently this one will be a problem. A little further. Teensy bit further. Teensy bit further. There we go. Whatever. Wilson! Where have you run off to? Oh, God! Now I'm already remembering why I didn't... I can hear him. Where are you? Come on, you monstrosity. This way. Oh. Dude, seriously. Wait here. Now follow me. Oh, honestly. Yeah, come on.
Jesus Christ.
Bad as Greg, you are. Just about as noisy, too. Come to think of it. For heaven's sake, man, it's a hill! Deal with it. Oh, I've got to start thinking like an AI companion now in terms of how I get around the landscape. This is why I left. Oh, really? You have a problem with water? Are you kidding?
What the...
How do you do that? Come on. Yes, Ashfallow Citadel. Many traumatic memories surrounding this place. This way. Oh, more ash hoppers, lovely. Or ash hunters, rather. One down. Oh! What are you do? Oh, you're shooting things. I approve. You better not have been shooting me. Whoa. Hello. Where are you? Dude! Oh, there you are. Oh, what? No, you've just... Ugh. I want them to have a closer look at you doing your whole Optimus Prime thing. Ah, oh, never mind. You're back in football mode. He'll find his way around, I'm sure. Oh, lovely. Annoying sound effects. Just what I need. I sincerely hope that's not you shooting me. Hello? Ugh, yes, there we go. Lunch, excellent. Oh, where's that bear? Come on, you. You're in my way. Wilson, a little help. Oh, there we go. Where are you? Oh, there you are. Keeping a safe distance, were we? Get past all this rubbish, we should find Thirsk around here somewhere, along with the big ass lake fielding. That's it. Ah, you know, inverted commas lake. At any rate, is there a standing stone around here somewhere? Never mind. Don't eat the green snow. Thirsk Mead Hall, right. Yes, hello, Rigglings. Of the non-hostile variety. So. Yes, we're here to find Bilgimuk, wouldn't you know it? Find Bilgimuk. Find Bilgimuk and give him some meat. Turn the forge into a cesspit. Charming. Bilgimuk. It's this way, apparently. Well, I have multiple quest markers. What's that about? Oh, I have a miscellaneous one pointing me to Skull Village. I suppose I could go there and talk to Nicholas, you know, while we're there. And decide for ourselves whether he ought to be going out to see the world in the first place. I mean, there's going out to see the world, sure, and then there's going out and getting yourself killed because you're not ready. Oh, so pretty! Oh, the game looks gorgeous like this. More sunlight, please! Less ash and less clouds. And fewer blizzards. Although it's getting a little chilly. Might as well wear the crossbow circle while we're at it. Snort. Come on, boy, I've got something for you. I was gonna save that for dinner. Come on, then. God, I'm turning into a traveling circus, I really am. Uh-oh. Oh! Thanks for the warning there. Where's Bilgimuk? There he is. I don't get it. What's all the fuss over a sodding bristleback?